Hey man, what's up everybody? Thank y'all for coming out. If you didn't know, that was Kyle's pitchy walk-up song. He was our closer on our wiffle ball team, and every game he'd come out, we'd play that song. A lot of us, it gives us chills hearing that song. He'd come out, he shut it down. He went 11-0 in his career. Crazy. He was crazy good. My name is Foster Huggins. This is Carson. We got some boys behind us, and this is Maddie Martin. We'll all be sharing memories of Kyle today, since a lot of y'all never got the chance to meet him. But if you didn't know, today is Kyle's 18th birthday, so real quick, I want to just sing happy birthday real quick. All right, ready? 3, 2, 1.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
Yes, sir. All right. So, I just real quick want to thank y'all so much for coming out. This is a nice crowd. If it was more sunny, I mean, this place might be just packed. But all y'all are really, we really appreciate it. Every single one of us appreciate every single one of you coming out. But like I said, since a lot of y'all never got the chance to meet Kyle, we're going to run through some memories real quick. I know a lot of y'all did know Kyle and would like to share a memory. So if that is one of you, make sure you find Connor Olson or Maddie Martin here that are videoing. Say your memory to the camera, and I'll make sure to put it in the tribute video that's going to drop on April 23rd. But let's get started. Maddie, you ready? All right, here we go.
Hold me up, bro. Okay, there's a lot more people than I thought there was. I'm Maddie Martin, if you guys don't know me. I've been a really good friend of Kyle since, like, fifth grade. One of my favorite memories is, if you know Kyle, you knew him by his smile. His smile literally lit up the room, and it was crazy how much it lit up the room. Also, one thing that really defined Kyle was his laugh. His laugh was very contagious. He might have been shy, but it was definitely a contagious laugh. My favorite memory of him is, where's Connor? Where are you? Connor Olson. Where? Oh, hi. Me and Connor and Kyle were called the Three Stooges in 5th and 6th grade, and I will always remember this, but you know how, like, in 5th and 6th grade, you're not really mature? Well, that was us. Us three were not mature at all. And if you know me, I'm definitely, like, the most mature person ever now. So, in 5th grade, we were called the Three Stooges, and we would get in trouble all the time. We would do things that we shouldn't have done. We were at Eagle Glen. We didn't really have recess. I mean, we did, but we just didn't have, like, the normal recess. We played kickball, basketball, all that. I was like the athletic girl at our school at the time. So we always played kickball, wiffle ball, all that, and we always did stupid stuff together, and we'd always get in trouble in class. But now I swear that we would never get in trouble in class now. So thank you guys so much for coming out. I don't know who's next, but Aiden Cantrell. Thank you guys.
So, my name is Aiden Cantrell, and I've known Kyle since about probably the third grade. And one of my favorite memories of Kyle was back then we played on the Monsters together, and I'd always line up with him. And after he stopped playing football, he got into hockey. And another one of my favorite memories is nights that we would stay the night together. I'd always wake up with him and go to him with his hockey games, because never really saw many people play hockey, but it's pretty cool.
My name is Jack Fields, and one of my favorite memories of Kyle was every single night for about 2 months straight, we would text till like 1 a.m. about like our lives, about anything, and he'd just tell me what's going on in his life. It was kind of nice to know. It was just nice texting him. Another favorite one of my memories was when he chipped my tooth when we were playing football. Fly high, bro. I love you.
My name is Nick Smith, and I was the same fourth grade class with Kyle. So one day, we're showing out at recess, and me and Kyle were smart. So we were where the teachers couldn't see us. We were like wrestling and stuff in the grass, and he got up behind me, and I threw him over my shoulder. And he thought that was the funniest thing. He was like, "How'd you do that?" I was like, "I don't know, it was crazy." So we go back inside, you know, we line up like we did in elementary school, And I don't remember what our teacher was doing. She had to go do something. So we're sitting in the hallway, unattended. So obviously we start messing around again, right? Now, I don't know how many of you remember us from fourth grade, but you know that Kyle was, you know, he was a pretty skinny dude. And I wasn't a skinny dude at all. So I got up behind him and he tried to throw me over him like I did to him. I just fell right on him. And of course, as soon as that happened, a janitor came out and just saw me tackle Kyle. So I got in trouble. I got sent to the safe seat. My mom got talking to him. She worked there at the time. And yeah, me and Kyle just laugh about it. And that's one of the things we like laugh about over the years. And happy birthday, Kyle. Love you, brother. And he got to show you something real quick. Tell me that's not the coolest thing ever. Alright, y'all. I'm gonna tell y'all about the last day I ever saw Kyle. It was April 22nd, 2017. And I remember we were gonna hang out that day. And he told me to come pick him up at like 12, so I went over. And when I got there, we went inside and he was blaring Hell's Bells, the song we played earlier, like so loud. Oh no. I'm finna start over. Alright, we finna start over real quick. We'll leave that. Alright, I'm gonna tell y'all about the last day I ever saw Kyle. It was April 22nd, 2017. He told me to come over because we were gonna hang out that day. And when I got there, I went inside. We were playing Hell's Bells, the song we played earlier. And he was playing it so loud on this new sound system at his dad's house. And it was like, I felt like my ears were gonna bust or something. It was crazy. And his dad got home and I thought he was gonna get in trouble because he was blaring music throughout the house. But his dad actually started jamming out with us. We're in his living room just getting lit to Hell's Bells. And then we went back to my house, and me and him and my brother Carson, we went fishing. We always had fishing derbies. I don't remember who won that day, but I do remember that me and Kyle got bored and did a rock skipping competition. I always used to beat him because I'm like the best rock skipper ever. But he actually beat me that day because he did one. It went across the whole pond, and it went up on the other side of the land. It was like, dude, that's unbeatable. And we went back to my house. At my house, Luke Long had a friend over. Yeah, Luke, I don't remember the kid's name, but he had a friend over. He came down and it was me, Luke, Carson, Kyle, and this kid. And we played baseball. We played catch in the front yard. And we always pretend like we were turning two. Like just, we were just playing around with the baseball. And then my mom ordered Papa John's. We went inside, ate Papa John's, and Papa John's always gives you a thing of garlic. And Kyle opens the thing and just licks it clean. He always used to do that. Do you remember that? I'm like, what are you doing? Oh my goodness. Yeah, it was disgusting. But then it was time for him to leave. So I took him home. And on the drive home, it was just me and him. And I said, he kept switching up his walk-up song for Wiffle Ball. I'm like, dude, you gotta stick with one. I'm like, what? I told him, I was like, I want to know, because I'm the one who has to change the walk-up songs. It takes forever. I'm like, dude, just stick with one, please. Like, what one do you want? And he told me, he said, Congratulations by Post Malone. And I was like, all right, bet. So, obviously, you know, I took him home. I told him, I said, I'll see you later, bro. He said, I'll see you. I drove off, and I looked back in my backseat. He forgot all his fishing stuff. So I turned back around, went and gave him his fishing stuff, and I said, you better not leave your fishing stuff in my car again, or we're gonna have to fight. And he said, you don't want to fight me. And that was the last thing I ever said to him. It was the next day that he passed away, and it was the day after that is when I found out. And I mean, I just want to say, like, that was the last thing I ever expected to hear on that Monday when I found out. And I just want y'all to just know how important it is to appreciate and love everyone around you, because Just think about it. You don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. You don't know what's going to happen in an hour or even 10 minutes from now. Anything can happen. That's why it's so important to appreciate and love
everyone around you. I feel like before Kyle passed away, I didn't really understand that, and that kind of just woke me up. Don't let a tragic situation be what wakes you up. Wake up today. Wake up right now. Start appreciating, loving everybody around you, because you know, you don't want to waste time. We don't know how much time we got together. That's all I'm saying. All right, I love y'all. That's all I got.
Guys, I'm Conlon, and Kyle is my best friend, and brother of all. I'm pretty sure my dad has a picture of us cuddling together in our sleep. One of my favorite memories is after school every day, we'd take the bus and we'd go back to Brian's house and hang out or play basketball. But we'd sit inside, talk for hours upon a time, and just be there with each other, and just we always had each other's back, and we all knew that. And Kyle would always make me go in the driveway and play hockey with him on roller skates, and I'm pretty sure I have like scars from that. He was way too good for me, and I just love him, and I miss him every day. Bye, Kyle.
What's up, everybody? I like to tell you guys a memory I had with Kyle, and it really shows our friendship the best, I'd say. One time, I just got a text from Kyle, and he's like, "Hey, you want to come over and hang out?" And I was like, "Yeah, sure." So I got my mom to go drop me off at his house. And we got there, and in the cul-de-sac in the middle, there's probably about 10 to 15 kids just sitting there with their cars all like around the cul-de-sac. And I was like, okay, whatever. So I thought me and Kyle were just going to go inside, but he had other plans, and he told me to come pick up a net and to go play tennis ball with him. And I was like, all right, that's fine with me. And if you don't know what tennis ball is, basically you get a metal bat, you get some tennis balls, and you basically hit them as hard as you can at anything or everything around you. So he basically takes his net to the middle of the cul-de-sac, where now there's just grown to about 20 to 30 people sitting in a circle with all of their cars around them. And he tells me to throw him one pitch. So I do. And he hits this ball right into the car window of a car to the left. And everyone in the cul-de-sac turns and looks at us and stands up and just starts screaming. And when I say I've never seen Kyle run faster, I mean, the dude took off to his house. And I'm like, dude, how are you going to leave me here with your net and all that? So I took off with him. I mean, what do you guys expect from like little seventh graders when a bunch of high schoolers and college students are screaming at you, you know? So we take off, and I mean, Pete comes outside with his dad, and he's like, "What are you guys doing?" And we do not flinch. We run right past him, run the door. We're like, we lock it, we go downstairs, and we just like hide out. And I mean, and this is like something you just expect from Kyle. I mean, he's always trying to have fun, just be the happiest person he could be, you know? You never really like. See, you never really saw anything in him other than just his great smile and everything he had, just happiness and all that. And that's what I really want to talk to you guys about. I mean, I need to make sure you guys are all just checking up on all your friends, because regardless if he seems happy or she seems happy, you never really know what's going on deep down. Just always make sure you keep everybody in check. You're never alone through it all, even if you do seem to feel like you are. You have so many people around you, and that shows today. Look at all you guys out here for us. Now we're going to bring up my brother again, and we're going to talk about some mental health and suicide awareness type stuff. Alright, basically, for suicide awareness, my mom gave us the idea we need to speak something on it, obviously. But really, all I have to say is, suicide is nothing but a permanent solution to a temporary problem. Any problem you have in your life, I don't care what it is, everything's temporary. Time heals all wounds, you will get over everything. Something my dad told me a long time ago. He said, life always eases itself out. No matter how bad things get, things will always get better in the future. And also, no matter how good things get, I mean, you can't be on top forever. Everything will kind of even out, you know? And something I just want to say is that I feel like a lot of people, when they commit suicide, because I feel like they're at the rock bottom. To me, if you're at rock bottom, that's actually like, don't be discouraged. Just feel like this. If you're at the rock bottom, the only direction you go from there is up. And it's going to be coming eventually. You know that. Time heals all wounds, bro. I remember the time I thought I was at rock bottom. Look at me now. Look at us now. I'm just saying, like, if you feel like you're honestly at a rock bottom, just look around you and just know how many people love you. And know that if you're literally at the bottom, if you're at the worst of your life, you can only go up from there. That should give you some courage. And I really like what my dad and Foster's dad told us, or our dad, I guess, what he told us. One dad, Eric Huggins. I really like that quote you told us. Even if you're at the bottom, you always know you're going up. And even if you're at the bottom, and like I said, you feel alone, you just have to reach out. I mean, I guarantee you, if you reach out to people in the next 1 minute, I bet you at least have 10 people like be there for you. Because everyone, like, look at this. I can look from my right all the way to my left, and I know every single one of you like has helped me out in this journey to be better. I mean, the week after this happened, I just remember how low I was, and I know how low Foster was, and every one of these guys in this truck. I know how hard of a situation it was for us, but just the support that every single one of you guys showed us, it really just helps bring you up. It just shows what really in life is gonna, where you're gonna go, and it's never gonna be the end until, you know, of age, you know.
Yeah, hey, for real, shout out to y'all. Y'all have helped us so much, not just us, all of us, everybody here. This is the whole family right here. I put this out there. I said, we're having a Kyle tribute day. It's going to be 45 degrees. It's going to be raining. And we're still going to make it happen. And look at how many people still pulled up. That means a lot. All y'all drove from Maryville, bro. That means a lot. And Max, I know you're here. I don't know where you're at. Thank all y'all, too. Driving all the way from Maryville, showing love. That's great. Thank you, guys. And thanks for everybody showing support over the years. Not just to us, to everybody. Like I said, everyone, if we come together, show love, I mean, mental health will be a thing of the past. But one more thing I want to say.
Yeah, and, you know, every single one of you guys here, you know, anything you're going through, me and Foster, everyone here, we've been through a lot, and we would always help you guys out, regardless of what the situation is or what it is. We love you all, we care about you all, and we know, and we all know that you feel the same way back, and it really shows a lot deep down, and we appreciate you all. Thank you, guys.
I have a question. What time is it? I mean, this kind of went a lot faster than I thought. If any of y'all want to come up and share a memory, just on the fly real quick, anybody? All right, but.
What's up, everybody? I didn't really know Kyle, but Foster's my boy, and I know a lot of you, like, mean a lot. Like, he means a lot to a lot of you guys, Connor, too. And just watching it, watching everything you guys post, and just like, I don't know. It's really dope to me. I didn't know Kyle, but I've lost people in my life, and seeing how you all come together, like, I want you guys really take this in, because when you get in real life and when you graduate college or high school, whatever you're doing, like this. Little stuff like this is what you'll think about. And like your deepest, downest times when you're alone, you'll think about all the people that supported you at your lowest. And sometimes it feels like no one's with you at your lowest, but I want you to always think about the smallest people that are with you, because even that smallest person might pick you up. I remember personally, I was suicidal when I was in college in Georgia State, and I had reached a really low point in my life. And that's when Foster and I got really, really super close, because I didn't really know who the dude was, and he's like listening to my music on SoundCloud, and he's like, bro, like, he's like hitting me up like all the time, like, bro, this is awesome. And I'm like in my room like, dang, like, like someone really thinks I'm dope. And so like now I'm like pushing this as a business, but like if someone like that never pushed me when I was low, I wouldn't be able to push this on a big scale. And like I'm really doing this for a lot of people now, and it's helping me do something for someone else. And so that little effort of just like, hey, bro, you're dope. You're helping me get through something. Made me get up and do more. So just always remember that. Take that with you wherever you go. Everybody here is special. I'm so glad that you guys are supporting each other. And I just wanted to say thank you. Thank y'all for supporting my boy. He's with my label, EMP. So I'm always going to push what he does. And if y'all support him, I support you. And let's just keep pushing and be positive and keep grinding, guys. I love y'all, and I hope y'all love me too. I called him Connor. I know your name's Connor.
All right, y'all. This balloon transition for this balloon release is about to take a while, because I think they're all tied up and stuff. So we probably should get into that. But before that, like I told you, hey, Randy, you're here? What's up, Randy? Okay. I told y'all that Kyle's walking song was Congratulations. If you watch the tribute video, I always put that song in there. You hear that song, you think of Kyle. So, in memorial of that, we're about to rock out to it. I invite y'all to get lit with us real quick. Give us a minute, though, because we got a little surprise.